Gurbani is like a mirror. We can see our life in Gurbani's mirror. Just like in real life, we see our face clothes in a mirror. The mirror shows us as a matter of fact. The mirror does not tell a lie. The mirror shows us how well we are dressed, how clean our face is. The mirror does not lie. Just shows things as they are now. In the same way, Gurbani is like a mirror. We can see everything in ourselves from Gurbani's mirror. When we read Gurbani, Gurbani will show us how dirty or clean our face, our mind is, how pure or polluted our mind is, whether our life is filled with sins or not. Gurbani too tells us about why we are born, what is life, why does one come into being on this earth, what is the purpose of life. On birth and the purpose of life, Guruji says, Pai Parapat Manukh De Huriya, Gobind Milan Ki Eh Teri Bariya. This human body has given to you. This is your chance to meet Lord. This is the purpose of life, why we are born. The next point is, what is the definition of birth? When God merges His power with five elements of mud, water, air, space and fire, this becomes the human body. This becomes the human body. When the soul and five elements develop in the mother's womb over a period of about 9 months, the human body is formed, develops and finally takes birth. This is the process of our birth. However, Guruji says in Gurbani that to get birth, it is not in our hands. It is under the command of Vaheguru. As we have heard a beautiful shabd from our Ragi Jatha, Guruji says, Zor na jeevan, maran hai zor. No power to live, no power to die. Our birth is not in our hands. We are not born because of our wishes. It is God's will. Likewise, the house owner, when a house owner builds a house, he does not ask the house how it should be built, the design, layout, where it wants to face. The house owner builds the house as per his wishes and preferences. Similarly, the house owner does not consult the house when it is to be demolished. Only the house owner decides. To this end, we have no control over our birth and death. God and God only knows about our birth and death. God destined that you are to be born on the earth and you were born. When taking birth, God does not ask which country you want to be born in. Into which ancestry do you want born into? Which color of skin do you prefer? If God were to ask these questions, everyone would want to be born as a rich person, in a rich family, with good ancestry, to have white color skin, without diseases, no illnesses, etc. But God did not ask us these questions. It is God's wish. The next point is, what is death? In this world, whoever takes birth must ultimately die. This is the law of nature created by God. And we humans have no control over this process. Everyone can be from any religion, caste, creed. Everyone will eventually die. So this is the law of nature. God made two aspects of everything. If there is day, there will surely be night. If there is light, must be darkness. If there is male, there will be female. Thus, where there is birth, there will surely be death. So, what happens when we die? When our soul is separated from our physical body, this is what we know as death. Guruji says that we will never know when we will die, how we will die, where we will die. God and only God knows about these details.